Okay, so in this video, I'm gonna show you how to use the Liquify tool in Photoshop. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you with a few different sample images. The first thing I'm gonna take is just like a landscape image. And this is super quick in Photoshop. So, you know, figure out what image you want to play around with. Really anything will work for your practice. I'm just gonna grab this landscape right here. And I'm getting this off of Unsplash. So I'm gonna copy image, and I'm gonna go ahead and paste this into Photoshop. So let me open my Photoshop. All right, so I've got Photoshop here. And I'm just pasting this on. I just said file new. I'm gonna throw this in here. Paste that in, and I'm gonna use my Liquify tool. When you are using your Liquify tool, I would recommend doing all your liquification, all your liquifying on a separate layer. So take a look up here. You're gonna take your image and you're gonna duplicate it. Do you remember how to duplicate? Control J. So I always like to create a second layer, and this is what I'm going to liquify. Liquify layer. That way if I mess up, I still have my original layer to go back to. So liquify layer here. And here's another tip. You might wanna save. The Liquify is pretty render intensive. It's going to put a lot of stress on your computer. So before you liquify, it's a good point, like if you've done a bunch of things, to go ahead and save your image. For mine, I haven't done anything yet, so I'm not gonna worry about it. But if you have, like, you know, progressed pretty far and you've done like a really intricate collage, now's a good time to save it before you liquify. All right, so to find the liquify, remember it's like up here for me, but that's just because it's my last used filter. If you want to get into Liquify menu, you need to go down here to Liquify. And there is a keyboard shortcut, Shift Control X. Okay, but I always find it just filter Liquify. I'm gonna go ahead and open the Liquify. It takes a moment to open. All right, and then I'm gonna get all these different menus and stuff here. So let me just talk about some of these things over here on the left. All right, I can see that this is a pretty low res image, so my brush is pretty big. I'm gonna use my brackets on my keyboard to make my brush bigger and smaller. All right, and over here are some different tools. So it just went ahead and started up in this forward warp. So let's see what that does. So I've got my brush here, and oh, there we go. So you can see that this just allows me to push my image around. So I can push different pieces around. Like so. And let's see what happens if I make my brush bigger. You can see that now it's a much bigger portion of my image that is being pushed around. Okay, Control Z works for the Liquify. So if you're in here and you know what, I don't want a small brush. I think I just want a really big brush because I want to just kind of morph this and give this like a little bit of a curve here. I can do like so. Okay, so that is the pushing. There's also the reconstruct. I honestly never use that. I think that's if you like kind of need to go back. The twirl is another useful one. The twirl. So let me show you what the twirl does. The twirl, when I click the twirl tool, I can twist it either clockwise or counterclockwise. So I can just click and I'm just holding my mouse and it's twisting my image. So it's twisting different portions of my image. And if I have a much smaller one, you can see that my little twist is gonna be smaller. So I'm just clicking and holding, and it's just twisting the portion that's inside that brush. All right, it goes kind of slow because the Liquify, again, is pretty render intensive. Okay, I'm also going to, if I wanna switch directions for my twist, let me see. I forget how to do it. I'm gonna look it up and I'll get back to you on that. There's, I think, a keyboard. Oh, it's option maybe? No, it's not that. Let's see if, I need to hold Alt, A-L-T, the Alt key. If I hold the Alt key, I twist the other direction. So clockwise, counterclockwise. Okay, so that's the twist tool. I'm gonna say cancel, because I don't like any of those liquifies. Filter, again, liquify. I can also tell the computer to just keep certain portions of the image. All right, so I'm doing my liquify. Let's say there's certain portions that I don't want to move. You're able to freeze different areas, bloat, pucker. I'm sure you can figure out what those do. Bloat is going to bloat this area versus pucker is going to squeeze this area in. Right? I'm squeezing it in. Right? So bloat and pucker. If there's certain areas that I don't want to be manipulated, I can use my freeze mask. Okay? So let's say I, let me see. Let me find like a good image to show you with the freeze. Let me find a different type image. All right. So I've got this other image here and I want to do some liquefy, kind of like one of those examples I saw here. So let's see. Again, I'm going to duplicate. Control J is duplicate. Filter. Liquefy. And again, it takes a moment to open. So let's see. I'm going to go ahead and just kind of push and pull some different sections of this image. And let's say I don't want my eye to be impacted. So here's an example of where I would use my freeze tool. So I can use my freeze and say, hey, don't stretch these features. Don't stretch this portion. Okay, and now when I use my pushing and pulling, you can see that that area is literally frozen. It's not moving. Okay, so I can still push and pull other areas around and it's not going to impact that one area there. Okay? And then if I want to unfreeze it, I can of course go here and there's an unfreeze. So I can thaw this out and now when I use my liquefy, I can move it. So play around when you're using the liquefy. You can move large pieces with your large brush, right? You can also shrink your brush down and create these small little movements, okay? So for the liquefy tool, that's pretty much it. It's filter, liquefy, play around, have fun with it. I'll show you one last thing. You can also just fill your canvas with colors. Whoopsies. I'm gonna do a new document. Just grab a piece of paper. You can create some interesting backgrounds. You can do a gradient. I'm just gonna go ahead and grab some large colors here and just paint with my brush. Oops, let me turn up my opacity. My brush is really putting some demands on my laptop today. I'll get one more color. I don't want to spend forever on this. Let's see here. Maybe I'll get a blue. All right, so I can also take just some like random colors. You can find stuff online. You can find a gradient and you can go up to the filter liquefy and just really quickly create your own backgrounds. This is just kind of fun to play with, right? So you can use your twirl. You can just go through here and you see very quickly I can make an interesting texture or background to use in some of my other works. You can also liquefy something twice. So let's say I have, you know, liquefied this here. I'm doing this kind of marbling thing. I can say, okay. I can duplicate it and I can re-liquefy it. So I've got this here. I can control J. Maybe I do something to it. Maybe I filter gallery. I don't know. Let's just do something. Okay, there we go. I added a filter to it. Let me add some ocean ripple, sure. And I can, again, go back again and filter, liquefy this again. Okay, so you can do it multiple times. So let's say now maybe I want to use my little twist. And I can go back and continue to liquefy this. All right, so that's it for the liquefy tool. Pretty easy to use. So create something interesting, right? We're doing some sort of band, music poster. Do something that looks cool. Okay, really anything can become liquefied for this project.